Hi YouTube, Michigan Snow Pony Renee, and with the help of my daughter Lena, today is part 5 of our Horse Crazy Kid series, and we're going to talk about tack and equipment and all the paraphernalia that goes along with owning a horse. Now you're probably going to think I'm going to talk about saddles and bridles and things like that first of all, but I'm not, because the most important part of this whole equation is what sits in the saddle, your child. And to that end, you're going to buy 2, to me, basic and absolutely mandatory pieces of equipment. And the first one is some kind of foot gear that provides at least, Lena, may I borrow your foot?
Yeah.
A half inch heel. Now, why do you need that heel? So that your child does not get their foot caught in the stirrup, theoretically. This keeps the stirrup, and whether you have English or Western, from sliding all the way in, because if your child's foot were to go all the way in and they fall off, they could theoretically, and it's happened, be dragged if the horse spooks and runs. So you want to prevent that. That's why you need foot gear with a heel. They even make riding tennis shoes with a heel. So you don't have to invest. This is just a muck boot, a rubber or vinyl boot. It's not expensive. And if you have growing children and you don't want to invest in those leather shoes and boots, go this route. And especially the way kids are, they stomp through mud puddles with them, and when they're cleaning stalls, these are perfect until they get full grown, and then you can invest in something a little more pricey. The second thing you're going to want is at the other end, and that's for their brain box, a helmet. And you want a well-fitting helmet. Lena, may I borrow yours? Even though you're not allowed to be on the horse without one.
Although I have been on a horse without mine.
Well, Mom doesn't need to hear about that.
Well, but you've watched me.
They make really lovely helmets, and they're not expensive anymore. You can get into one of these for about $39 or even cheaper on sale. And they're lightweight, they breathe, they have holes and
that's
mesh.
My favorite helmet.
And can you hold this, honey, because I'm one-handed? I want to show you this feature that a lot of them have now. Used to be fitting was always interesting. And now they have this little button.
Dial.
That makes your helmet tighter or looser in the back. So when she has a friend come over, we have a couple of these, we can really get the helmet fitting well for the friend, and they don't have to make an investment. And they're good to have on hand, especially if you're going to have multiple children riding, you know, even one at a time, you can make the one helmet theoretically fit for all of them, providing they're roughly the same size. But you always want to have your chin strap adjusted fairly tight.
Two fingers, I believe.
Yeah, that's for the horse chin strap, honey, but that's okay. One finger maybe for you. Anyway, very important to have them fitted well. We were at a horse show a few weeks ago, and horrific thing, a very small child, about 7-ish, was over-mounted, meaning they were on a horse way too big and spirited for them. And they came off in the ring when the horse decided to buck, and the child went one way and the horse, or the helmet, went the other. And she hit the ground, oh my gosh, with a splat after flying about 10 feet up in the air and 20 feet in front of that horse if it was a foot. And I was never so happy and relieved to see a child screaming and moving as when this little girl did. But I really questioned how well that helmet was fitted on her.
I don't even think it was done up. Well,
later on, we saw the mom riding the same horse without a helmet, so I don't think Mom really had a lot of respect for helmets. I think she was putting one on her child so she could go in the ring, but another video for another day. So those are 2 basic pieces of equipment that you want to buy first. Yes, first. Before anything for the horse, you outfit your child. Okay, there's one more piece of equipment I want to show you, but she doesn't have to use it with Cricket, just when she's riding Dakota.
And Sunny.
Anyway, I'm going to show you that.
Now, this is something you may or may not feel is necessary. If your child is going to get into jumping or anything kind of rough and ready, you may want to invest in one. They're riding vests and venting vests. And what it is it's very heavy padded, lightweight, but padded vest. It goes down to protect their tailbone and their kidneys in the back. I'm not getting a very good shot of this. Let's see, it goes all the way down past their waist, and it just kind of helps them if they were to fall off. Now, Lena has to wear this if she rides Dakota or if she gets on my mare, because my mare's a little taller, and it just gives her a little extra shock absorption. And they're very adjustable, so even though they're pricey, they're usually over $100, folks. But they're very adjustable. The very first one that I bought for Lena, she was was about four, and she wore that till she was 8 or 9 years old, because these Velcro straps come off and you can make them wider, you can adjust the shoulders, make them shorter, longer, and so that aspect of them is wonderful. And after they do outgrow one, you can put it on Craigslist or eBay and pretty much get your money back out of them. So this happens to be a youth medium. It fits Lena. She's about 90 pounds soaking wet, about 4'10". Anyway, and this is a comfort zone for the parent thing. If you feel it's necessary, great. Especially if you got a beginner rider, maybe it'll give your child some extra confidence to wear one of these. They're a little uncomfortable to get used to, but I know she's been happy to have it the time she's fallen off with one.